Everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Canna Campbell. Before we begin today's video, a very quick shout out to my two very different Instagram accounts. Over here, we have the Sugar Mama account. This is where I provide you with all of your financial motivation, inspiration, and most importantly, education to achieve all your financial goals and dreams. And then of course, over here, we have the Canna Campbell official Instagram account. And this is where I share with you, it's so much fun, this account, I'm really enjoying it. It's a creative account and it's where I share with you my capsule wardrobe fashion, beauty, motherhood, minimalism, lifestyle, and basically me trying to keep it together in a challenging modern day world as I try not to lose my SH1T all the time. Now, on that note of keeping it together in a challenging modern day world, that's what today's video is about. People always say to me like, Canna, how are you so calm and rational and you know, how are you dealing with this and be okay and that and be okay and how are you dealing with all of this? Only this morning someone said to me, wow, when it rains for you, it really does pour. And I'm someone who's hypersensitive. I take things very personally. I don't take criticism when it's not delivered very well. I can be very defensive and I'm emotional. I cry, I get frustrated, I get annoyed. And there's a reason why Tom calls me nutjob millionaire. And at the moment I can share with you, I'm having a challenging time. This morning we got confirmation that it looks like Sophia is really on her last legs and we're probably going to have to put her down this week, which is really heartbreaking. I've also got my facial exam in 2.5 weeks, which is very high pressure. And on top of that, nausea is back. I got really sick when I, for the first 14, 15 weeks of my pregnancy. I'm now, I think, 22 weeks and I'm back to vomiting every day. So it's a little bit challenging at the moment. I will be very honest and admit I'm having a tough time trying to keep my shit together. But I want to share with you some of the things that I do in my life that really help me maybe not lose it so badly, or if I do lose it, it doesn't spread into 1,000,000,000,000,000,000 pieces across the room. It's just, you know, like a nice neat mess that I can just quickly sweep up and get on with my life. So this is not about me being, you know, telling you what to do. Just maybe pick what might you think might sound like a good idea and try it and let me know if it works. And of course, if you have a better idea or more ideas, please put them in the comment box below because sharing is caring. All right, so the first tip for keeping it together in a modern day challenging world is, and that is time alone. I need time alone. I need to recalibrate, reground myself, catch my breath, and just gain a sense of perspective again. This is happens when I'm on my own, whether it be 5 minutes, whether it be 5 hours, I need to make sure I'm in tune with myself when I need that time. And the moment I feel it, I either put my hand up and say, hey, I just need 5-10 minutes to myself, or I know I need actually a whole day to myself, or maybe even a whole weekend to myself, and I'll go and schedule it in my diary so I actually make it happen. Now, I know that's hard to do, but sometimes you've got to take what you can get. And if it means I can get 5 minutes on my own and I can lock myself in the cupboard, I will take that, because sometimes that's just enough to get me through for a little bit longer, to last until I can have like an hour to myself or even longer. So time alone. Now that might be for someone going and taking themselves to get, you know, a coffee or a beautiful salad. It might be going for a walk. It might be just sitting in the room, staring into space, maybe lighting a candle or locking yourself into the closet like I sometimes like to do, or just maybe taking a snack with you into that closet. All right, my second bit of advice is the power of 10. Now, I'm a little bit OCD. I like things to be tidied and organized. So I will always make sure that I try and go to bed with the house tidy. Now, this is not always possible when you're tired. I think of the power of 10. So I'll do one of three different things. Number one is I will just simply put away 10 things before I go to bed. You might be like, oh, it's 10 things. Hang on, 10 things actually make the room look a lot tidier than you would realize. The other thing, which is the better one option of the three, and that is set a timer before you go to bed, get the kids down and everyone else goes, and that is to have timer on and you've got to try and beat the clock, and you've got to try and put away, tidy or wipe down as many things as you possibly can in your main living area or whichever living area you want, whether it includes the bedroom or not, up to you, and try and beat the clock. And you'll be amazed, because the challenge of trying to beat the clock and rush and get it done, you just power through and are so efficient in creating a really tidy, clean, organized space. You feel so good after that alarm goes off. And I have to say, coming down in the morning when I have some time alone to myself, assuming Apple doesn't wake up super early, it is something really magical and spiritual, just sitting in a really calm, tidy, clean space all to yourself with no one coming in to mess it for at least 15, 20, 30 minutes. The third option, which is something I've recently started doing, is I will sometimes, you know, if I'm tired but not too tired, I will flick the kettle to have like a peppermint tea or a nighttime tea, or hot Ribena is my new thing. And whilst the kettle is boiling, I will try and use that time to clean as many things as possible. But it means my space is just a more harmonious environment to begin my day off. I started off on a, I guess, a calmer, more rational headspace. The third thing that I recommend, and this is for everyone, and that is embracing minimalism. When you have less stuff, you have so much more time, you have so much more clarity. Now, this means like literally going through all your stuff and just, you don't do it at your own pace and when you feel inspired and when you feel energized to do it. And of course, there is a fine line with minimalism because it means you need to be very organized with your stuff, particularly your washing if you're going to have less clothes, because you need to make sure you've always got clean clothes, which is one of the things I learned quickly about minimalism. But, you know, embracing less, you can find things easy. It's quicker and easier to keep things organized. You value your things more. You just feel lighter and you just simplify your life, which is worth $1 million in itself. The fourth advice for just keeping it together in a modern day world, and that is to get up early. I know this is such a cliche thing, but it really does work. Whenever I've told girlfriends to try it, they're like, yeah, you know, I hated it. It took a while for me to get used to it, but I really see the benefits of it and I really love that. And often, because that is your time alone before the world begins, before emails start going, notifications starts going off, text messages are coming in, people are messaging on different social media apps. It's a magical time. Get up early, even if it's only 15 minutes. I promise you, you'll end up finding that time very, very sacred and you'll be more inspired to wake up early. And that's particularly with children because, as I say, that, you know, they can be very draining as beautiful as they are. The fifth thing that I recommend, and that is lists. I always try and recommend that you do your list of things to do before the day begins. So you do your list before you go to bed or before you leave work and leave it on your desk. And this is my other secret hack, and that is do the easiest things first on your list. Things that you can get done quickly, you're easy, use the minimal amount of brain cells because you start to build a momentum. You're getting into the list, you're powering through, writing that, and as you get through the easy ones, you can start tackling the more challenging, harder ones as you go through. But it's lists are everything. Actually, here's my list of things to do today. And I have to say, even though I've already had a tough morning, I've already powered through a lot of things already. And I also chipped my tooth this morning and I've managed to squeeze in an emergency dental appointment to get that fixed. My sixth tip, and this is a really important one, and that is to find humor. When I learn to just step back and just laugh and just go, this is so messed up, this is so crappy, this situation, I just can't cope anymore, I learn to see the funny things in life. So this morning, Apple weed all over the floor because we didn't get a nappy on her in time. And then at the vet, Sophia weed all over me. And in me, this is really embarrassing, I can't believe I'm gonna tell you this on YouTube, but me also in sneezing and bending over at the same time, I had my own little leakage. Now, this was a really tough emotional morning for our family, and I was like, well, all the women in the house are basically incontinent to a certain degree. So in that moment, I just had to laugh and go, oh my God, wow. Like, this is real life. Wow, what, are we really doing it? And it just helped kind of break that comic relief, really. It broke the tension, gave me an opportunity to breathe again and laugh again and try and see the positive in the world. And, you know, even the other day, I was about to strangle Tom because he was saying that he tidies up all the time. I was like, no, you don't. And we were about to launch into an argument. And I turned around to him and I said, you're not, he likes to think he's a bit of a rap artist. And I'm like, you think you're 50 cent, but actually you're 50% because you clean up only to the level of 50%. And we both started laughing at each other. And even Rocco like chimed in saying, yeah, you're 50%. Obviously in a very funny way, but just try and find the humor in those moments because sometimes things just get so crappy. The only thing left to do is to laugh. The seventh tip for keeping it together in a challenging modern day world, and I've been doing this for years, even though it's been written about in books, I've just always done this automatically, and my weekend in my head is not Saturday morning till Sunday evening or afternoon. My weekend is actually Friday afternoon, the moment my brain starts clocking off, all the way through to Monday morning when I walk out the door on my way to work. Now, if I think about it that way, a weekend's not just 2 days, a weekend is really almost 3 days. And it means I make the most of the moment I'm clocked off and I'm with my family, I'm with my kids, I'm with Tom, or I'm catching up with girlfriends, or I'm doing some exercise, I make my weekends count. I don't jam-pack them, but I make sure I'm getting a little bit of everything I need to then help me get through the next week ahead. But I really, it makes me embrace every single second within the week. And I don't just sit there and think, oh, it's only 2 days. No. It begins on Friday afternoon and it ends on Monday when you go to work. So make every minute of your weekend really count. Fill it up with quality, not quantity. And then the eighth and final hack or recommendation for keeping it together in a modern day world, and that is ask for help. As Tom says to me when I'm trying to do it all, he's like, stop trying to be a martyr. Put your hand up, ask for help. Don't be afraid. Like, and I hate it when he says it because it really irritates me. But he's right. You know, we're not robots. We're not superpowered people. We're human. And sometimes we need downtime. Sometimes we need time alone. Sometimes we just need to change things up and do things differently. And we're all juggling different challenges going on at the same time. So if you think you're struggling, call a friend and say, hey, I'm struggling. Can you help me out? Or is there any chance you could do this or that? Or, and you know, I have to say, and I've shared this in other videos, I remember there are times where my girlfriends would call me and say, I'm about to strangle my children. And I'd be like, no problem. I'll swing by in half an hour and I'll grab them. And I'll take them for a couple of hours to the park with my kids. We're not superhumans, but we are trying to be superhuman beings whilst we're here. So that means being real. That means being honest. And that means being human. And that means putting your hand up and saying, hey, I need some help. Can you help me delegate? Can you help take some of the responsibility? Or can you work with me on helping me get through this challenging time? It's okay. It's perfectly normal. All right, everyone, that is enough nattering for me with my work-life balance hacks and how I try to keep it together in a modern day world. I wish everyone a fantastic week. Ciao for now.